Today we're going to be making a cardboard rover. You'll need 1 6-inch square of cardboard, 2 5-inch squares of cardboard, some tape, a pair of scissors, a pencil, and a plastic straw, as well as 2 pieces of hard candy and 2 rubber bands. Let's get started. First, we're going to make the body of our rover by taking the 6-inch square of cardboard and marking it into thirds using our pencil. You're going to want to fold along each one of these little marks until you form a kind of basket where the driver of the rover could sit. And once you've folded these sides up, you will have the body of your rover. Now we're going to make the wheels of our rover. So taking one of the 5-inch squares of cardboard and your pencil, draw a line running diagonally from each corner of the square. This is going to create a large X, and where these 2 lines intersect right in the middle of the piece of cardboard, you're going to take your pencil and you're going to puncture a little hole. And you're actually going to push your pencil all the way through until the pencil is sitting nice snugly within the center of the cardboard. And you should be able to turn the cardboard along the pencil like this. And then you're going to repeat this step with the other 5-inch square of cardboard. Now we're going to make the first axle of the rover. So you're going to want to flip each side up, and you're going to want to kind of visualize what would be 2 parallel points that your pencil would be able to fit through. So you're going to make little dots in the corner of each one of those side pieces, and you're going to, once again, use your pencil to puncture all the way through the cardboard, but this time you can make the hole a little bit bigger by twisting your pencil around while making the puncture holes. And this is going to make sure that when the pencil is spinning with the wheels, your whole body of your rover isn't going to be spinning as well. So make sure to make large enough holes on both sides of those flaps, with the goal being that the pencil will be able to run through both of those holes and sit nice and parallel with the bottom of the rover. Now we're going to attach the wheels to our rover. So taking your pencil, you can thread it through those 2 holes that we just made, and then you can grab each one of your wheels and attach via threading the pencil through those holes right in the center. Now we want to make sure that the wheels and the pencil are securely attached, so we're going to use a lot of tape to just tape the cardboard and the pencil together, and then this way when we wind it up, the pencil and the cardboard wheels will spin, but it hopefully won't spin the whole body of the rover. So make sure you use enough tape. Don't be afraid to use a lot of tape in this process. You're going to want to tape both the outside portion as well as on the inside where the wheel meets the pencil. And you're going to want to make sure that the wheels are parallel and that both sides are facing the same direction and are able to lay flat on the ground. And just want to make sure that this is very sturdy and secure. The wheels are a very big part of this rover, so you want to make sure that they're on nice and tight and that they're both parallel and facing the same direction. Now we're going to make the motor for our rover. The rover is powered by the tensile strength of rubber bands, so we're going to tie our 2 rubber bands together by pulling one through the other and then back through itself, so it'll make a kind of bow tie shape with the 2 bands knotted together in the middle. And we're going to wrap the rubber band around our pencil, once again pulling one end through the other and then back through itself so it forms a secure loop around the pencil, just like that. And next we're going to take our pair of scissors to cut 2 little slits in the front end of the rover. They don't have to be super long or equidistant from each other. They are just going to create a spot for the rubber band to attach to, so it'll be nice and taut in our rover, just like this. And now our rover is ready to go. To get your rover moving, you're going to wind the large cardboard wheels backwards so that the rubber band wraps multiple times around the pencil, and this will propel the rover forward. You're going to want to really wind this thing up because it takes a lot of the tensile strength of the rubber band to get the rover really moving. So if you're struggling, don't worry about it. It takes some tinkering with to get it really moving. Some troubleshooting tips are making sure that the wheels are all lined up, both the front and the back wheels, and that they're securely fastened. Having a rougher surface also helps for the rover gain some traction. But most importantly, you're going to want to make sure that you have strong enough rubber bands, because that is the motor of this thing, and that is what's going to really get it moving.